Geothermal Rising, as well as help initiate a student chapter at the university at Geothermal Rising. So basically, here is the booth for Geothermal Rising student committee. So let me just start quickly by just sharing some of the benefits of being a student member or joining the Geothermal Rising. Basically, the main idea is the sense of belonging. So we all have like a mutual, I would say, goal or a mutual benefit that we are looking for, or a mutual interest, which is the geothermal energy. So the first thing is to have like a network and an environment of people sharing the same goals and the same interest of developing and increasing the awareness, or spreading the awareness about geothermal rising. So one of the good things about being a student member is that you will be actively informed about the scholarships, the funds that's available, the conferences, workshops, everything. So you will be always updated about the news and information. And also the second thing is you have an access to the largest geothermal library when you are a member. So you can log in, download any papers related to the geothermal energy, such as like the Geothermal Rising conference right now we're having. So you can access all the papers through that library. And also, so you'll have an access also to the technical sessions, as well as the workshops for your own professional development as a student. And you will have also a membership to the International Geothermal Association, which is also a big gathering of folks, so professionals in the geothermal energy. And also you will have a very good opportunity networking to professionals, and they were all like going through the same journey, so sharing their experience, sharing their what they have gone through to get to that position of being like a professional or having a huge experience about the geothermal energy. Such events like the conference and the workshop, you can get into contact with them. So we have one here also, right? Connor. It's one of the professionals right now. He's transitioning from student to a professional. So the registration process is actually very simple. What you need to do is you need to log in to the student to get to the Geothermal Rising conference. And the link, I can show you like briefly how the website looks like in a bit. And then you click on the membership panel, and then you will find like a student tab. So you can click on the student tab and click join, and you can create an account and then proceed with the payment, which costs around $20 for students. And also, if you cannot afford that, the Geothermal Rising Student Committee is offering sponsorship for students that who cannot pay or who cannot afford the $20. And there is a form that you can fill online, and you will get like later on the activation of your membership. So, and here is the form, the link form. We can share them also in our social media accounts, as well as by email. So just stay connected with us. So the other part of the presentation will be talking about how to initiate Geothermal Rising student chapter at your school. So basically, being a member or student member, I mean, we know that the common cliche that one hand cannot clap. So you need some environment, like small environment with you, sharing the same environment. slash sharing the same ideas and knowledge. So this is the main benefit of being in student chapter, belong the student chapter, below the Geothermal Rising student committee. So the process is really simple. The process starts with your school. So if you are a student at any school and you have some folks or students that interested in the geothermal energy, what you can do, you can start by creating a club or organization at the school, and the procedure is different from school to another. So some schools require a specific number of students in order to start the process. Some of them requires maybe some positions, so you can you need like to have advisor, either a faculty member or a staff member to start the process. So it's different, it depends on your school. You have to check with your school and then come back and start the process. After you initiate the chapter, you can start contacting the student committee, the Geothermal Rising student committee, through our social media accounts or through the presentations, through the email. Send your interest that you want to create a chapter and you already started the process at your school. So later on we will send you some files, documents you need to fill out. Basically there are two documents. The first one is the student chapter affiliation letter, which gives you like the affiliation of the Geothermal Rising. So your club or organization will be belonging to working under the Geothermal Rising student committee, as well as the bigger community, which is the Geothermal Rising. And the other one is the constitution. And the constitution is something flexible. We will send you like something like a template, and then you can change that according to the school's regulations. Because we know that some schools, they don't have like kind of regulations for the student organization. So we give like kind of template, and I can also show you that template. So you can modify that and fill it out, fill both of them, both documents, and then send it to us by email. And then we will have some time reviewing the documents, and we will get back to you in less than a week. So after the documents are okay, so we'll send you the affiliation approval, and then you will be having an affiliation with the Geothermal Rising. After that that process usually takes like less than a month. And you have to do this like every year. You have to renew the affiliation every year. So it's like right there, and you're gonna do the same process. You already have the members at your school. You already have the club. What you need to do is just update the files with the positions, and then you will get that approval again. So I think that's all. And if you need if you have any further questions about the process or how it goes, you can just reach us through our social media accounts as well as through the emails. And here are our social media accounts, and I'll be glad if you have any questions.